Now let us try to understand the cylinder synchronization circuit. Now difference between sequencing and synchronization we need to understand. Sequencing means one after the, we have to achieve the motion of multiple cylinders one after the other. Like so extension of cylinder one will takes place first in the beginning. Then at the end of extension of cylinder one, extension of cylinder two will start. Then extension of cylinder 3 will start and so on. In the retraction of cylinder 3 will start. Then it will end at the end of retraction of cylinder 2, retraction of cylinder 3, retraction of cylinder 3, retraction of cylinder 2 will start, and at the end of retraction of cylinder 2, retraction of cylinder 1 will start. So that was sequencing. Now synchronization means we have to operate two cylinders or multiple cylinders in synchronous manner. Now meaning of synchronization, as far as the motion of multiple cylinder is considered, then it can be achieved by keeping the velocities of all cylinders which are connected to each other. The velocity of all cylinders must be same. So that means extension of all cylinders must start at the same point. So all cylinders will extend at the same time and all cylinders will retract at the same time. So that means velocity of all the cylinders must be same, then only all cylinders will extend at the same time and even they will retract at the same time. So that is what is called as synchronization circuit. Now the first arrangement to achieve synchronization is that you have to attach the multiple cylinders in parallel way or in parallel. So we have two double acting cylinders and they are connected in parallel. Why? Because if you can see over here, the port A and port B is connected to blank end. So port A is connected to blank end of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2, and port B is connected rod end, it is connected to rod end of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 at the same time. So what will happen, we will see the working of this circuit. So when I operate this solenoid, this first position will come into picture. So liquid which is being delivered by this pump will follow this line. It will come to P. It will delivered from P to A, and from point A it will come to this junction. Now it will start moving to blank end of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 at the same time. Since liquid is liquid has started entering from blank end of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 at the same time, these two cylinder will start their extension at the same time. And obviously at the same time we have to remove the liquid which is available at rod end of both the cylinders. So this rod end of both the cylinder is connected to this junction and then it is connected to point B, port B. So in the first position B is connected to T. So liquid which was available at rod end of cylinder 1 and 2 will be taken out and it will be supplied to the tank. But now you should understand one important point, that the load acting on both the cylinder must be same and the areas of both the cylinder must be same. Then and then only both the cylinder will start extending at the same time. Okay, so you have to understand this point very, you have to keep this point in your mind, because load acting on both the cylinder, if it is same, then the pressure which is created by this both loads will be same and thus the extension will start at the same time. On the other hand, to achieve same velocity of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2, you need to keep the areas of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2, they must be same. So blank end area of or piston area of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 must be same, and at the same time rod end area of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 must be same. So if you achieve this condition where the cylinder 1 area and cylinder 2 area they are same, and at the same time load acting on both the cylinder is same, then and then only these both cylinders will extend at the same time and even they will retract at the same time. So to achieve retraction of these two cylinders at the same time, I will activate this solenoid. So this third envelope will come into picture. So liquid which is being delivered to port P will be connected to B. So it will, from B it will come here, and liquid will start entering from rod end of both the rod end of cylinders. So the retraction of both cylinder will start at the same time. On the other hand, liquid which was available at blank end of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 will come into this junction and it will come to port A, and since port A is connected to T, The liquid which is available at blank end of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 will be given to the tank. Again, provided the condition that load acting on both the cylinder is same, so that pressure at retraction of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 will be same, and if their areas are same, then the velocity of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 for retraction will be kept same. So this is how synchronization can be achieved for two cylinders when they are connected in parallel. Okay. Now let us try to understand one more situation. Let us assume that areas of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2, they are same, but load acting on cylinder 1 is less and load acting on cylinder 2 is more. Now assume that the load acting on cylinder 1 is less, that will create less pressure. Load acting on cylinder 2 is more, so that will create more pressure. So obviously the cylinder 1 will extend first and then cylinder 2 will extend. Why? Because load acting on cylinder 1 is less, so that will create less pressure. So to achieve extension of this cylinder, we need less pressure. So obviously cylinder 1 will extend first because it requires less pressure. So after achieving the extension of cylinder 1, cylinder 2 will start extending because it requires more pressure, it has more load. So if it is a condition that load acting on cylinder 1 is less and they are connected in parallel, then the cylinder 1 will extend first and then cylinder 2 will be extended. So this will be a case of cylinder sequencing circuit or cylinder sequencing operation. Okay. So now let us try to understand cylinder synchronization operation when two cylinders or multiple cylinders, they are connected in series. Now to connect the two cylinders or multiple cylinders in series, what we have to do is we have to connect port A to blank end of cylinder 1, then rod end of cylinder 2. Port which is available at rod end of cylinder 1 must be connected to port which is available at blank end of cylinder 2, and port which is available at rod end of cylinder 2 then must be connected to port B. Okay. So this is how cylinders, we can say both cylinders, they are connected in series. I will repeat once again. Port A is connected to blank end of cylinder 1. Port which is available at rod end of cylinder 1 is connected to blank end of cylinder 2. And port which is available at rod end of cylinder 2 is connected to the port B. So this is how connected two cylinders, they are connected in series. Now here also we have to achieve extension of both the cylinders at the same time and retraction of both the cylinders at the same time. Then we can say they are connected in synchronous, or they are operated in synchronous manner. Now to achieve the extension of both the cylinders at the same time, what we have to do is, since we know the condition that load acting on both the cylinders must be same and areas of both the cylinders, they must be same when they are connected in parallel. But now here, since we have to operate these two cylinders at the same time, what we have to do is we have to keep one condition in mind, that since rod end of cylinder 1 is connected to blank end of cylinder 2, what we have to do is we have to keep the liquid which is coming from, or the liquid which is coming from rod end of cylinder 1, its discharge, that is, let us assume it as Q1. So Q1 must be equal to Q2, then only we can say that both the cylinders, they are extending at the same time. So the discharge of the cylinder 1, when the discharge which is coming out from cylinder 1 must be equal to discharge which is being supplied to cylinder 2 from its blank end, then only we can achieve this condition. Okay. So now what we will do is we will write that Q1 out, or Q out of cylinder 1, that is, discharge which is, or the liquid which is coming out of cylinder 1 must be equal to discharge which is being supplied at blank end for cylinder 2. Then we can achieve its synchronization when they are connected in series. So we can further equate it as, we can write this Q, that is discharge, which is equal to area into velocity. So that means area of cylinder 1 into its velocity must be equal to area of cylinder 2 into its velocity. Now effective area, why they are saying it as effective area? Because for cylinder 1 the effective area will be rodent area, and for cylinder 2 the effective area will be blanket area. So that is why they are written like this. Okay, so let us solve this again. So as I already said, effective area for cylinder 1 will be considered as its rodent area, so it will be AP1 minus AR1, because this is the annulus area of cylinder 1, whereas effective area for cylinder 2 will be only AP2. So we will replace this A effective for cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 with AP1 minus AR1 into velocity of cylinder 1 equal to AP2 into velocity of cylinder 2. So since for the synchronization we will get the result, as since velocity of cylinder 1 and cylinder 2 must be kept same, so this V1 and V2 will get cancelled because they are same. So it the equation remains as AP1 minus AR1 is equal to AP2. So this justifies what I stated just before few minutes, that effective area of cylinder 2, that means the discharge which is coming out of cylinder 1 must be equal to cylinder the discharge which is being supplied at blank end of cylinder 2, and that is why we have to keep the areas of annulus area of cylinder 1 must be equal to rod end blank end area of cylinder 2. Okay, so this is how by summing up all the forces which is being supplied which is being acted on cylinder 1 and cylinder 2, we can write it in such fashion that let us try to identify the forces acting on cylinder 1. Now for cylinder 1 there are three forces. First is F1, then cylinder force which is being exerted on this piston, that will be equal to AP1. Since we are considering the forces, we can write this equation as P1 into AP1, so which is written here. So P1 into AP1, this is the first force, and which is acting from left hand side to right hand side, and that is why it was kept positive. So it is positive P1 into AP1. This is the first force. Now second force will be, because this line rod end of cylinder 1 is connected to blank end of cylinder 2, so this line will experience also, it will also experience some force. So that force will be equal to AP1 minus AR1 into P2, and it will be acted from right hand side to left hand side in this direction, from right hand side to left hand side, and it thus its sign will be kept as minus, you can see over here. So second force will be P2 into AP1 minus AR1, and lastly we have this particular force F1. So now again this force is acting from right hand side to left hand side, again the sign convention for F1 will be also equal to minus, but since it is shifted to other side of this equal to sign, it will become plus F1. Okay, so this was force summation of forces which were acting on first cylinder. Similarly on the second cylinder again some of the forces they are acting. So for again cylinder 2, pressure will be exerted, or cylinder force will be exerted from left hand side to right hand side on this piston, so which will be equal to AP2 into P2. Since it is acting from left hand side to right hand side, it will be plus, you can see over here, P2 into AP2. Now again cylinder force will act from this side, so it will be equal to AP2 minus AR2 into P3. Now since it is acting from right hand side to left hand side, it will be minus, you can see over here, P3 into AP2 minus AR2. And lastly the external force which is acting on this cylinder, which is F2, which is also acting from left right hand side to left hand side, so it will be minus, but when it is shifted to other side it becomes plus. So this is the summation of forces acting on cylinder 2. So now if we consider these two equations, that the forces which are acting on cylinder 1 and forces which are acting on cylinder 2, now we have to add these two equations. So if we add these two equations, what will happen? So this F1, let us consider the right hand side first because they are simple. So F1 and F2 will be added on the right hand side of this equation. Then if we consider the left hand side, what will happen? AP1, P1 into AP1 minus P2 into AP1 minus AR1 plus P2 into AP2 plus P3 into AP2 minus AR2. So now if you observe this term carefully, you will find that since this line, we are considering this area, no? AP2 minus AR2 into P3, but this line is connected to port B and B is connected to T. So simply this line, since this line is connected to tank, the pressure which is generated in this particular line because of these two areas, I mean this area and this P3 pressure, since this line is connected to tank, P3 will be zero because this line is directly connected to tank. So pressure which is being generated over here will be almost equal to zero. So this term P3 into AP2 minus AR2 will become zero. Okay, so he term geli mata kay rahila AP1 P1 into AP1 minus P2 into AP1 minus AR1 and P2 into AP2. Now since we have studied that in the previous slide, AP1 minus AR1 is equal to AP2. So if you see here, AP1 minus AR1, and here we have term AP2 along with the same pressure P2. So if pressure is same and even the areas they are same, and where for this term we have negative sign and here we have positive sign, so these two term will also get cancelled. So we only this term will remain same. So P1 into AP1 must be equal to F1 plus F2. So to achieve extension of both the cylinder at the same time and retraction of cylinder at the same time, what we have to ensure that force which is being exerted or which is being generated by cylinder, which is equal to P1 into AP1, must be equal to external loads which are acting on cylinder, both the cylinder, summation of external loads acting on both the cylinder, that is F1 plus F2. So F1 plus F2, they are kept in such fashion that the cylinder force which is being generated or exerted at this point must be equal to their summation. So when force 1 and force 2, they are kept, addition of these two force must be considered to create pressure at this particular point. Then and then the synchronization of two cylinders can be achieved. So this was both the cylinders they were connected in series, and we are achieving this the operation of both the cylinders in synchronized manner. So you have to keep this condition in mind that pressure which is being exerted at blank end of cylinder 1 must be equal to summation of external forces acting on both the cylinders, that means F1 plus F2. And this condition that the discharge which is coming out of cylinder 1 must be equal to discharge which is being supplied to cylinder 2. Okay.